So now that we've defined our Vagrant file, let's go ahead and start our Vagrant server. So you start the Vagrant server using the Git bash if you're on Windows, or the terminal if you're on Mac or Linux. So again, like we did with the Vagrant init tool, we're going to interact with Vagrant using the command line interface. The way that you start a server is you make sure that you are in, you're working on the, you're changed into the directory for the project where there is a working Vagrant file, and you simply type Vagrant up. When you type Vagrant up from a location which has a Vagrant file, Vagrant detects that there is a Vagrant file and it creates a virtual server using VirtualBox to the specification we described in this file. So we said that we wanted the server to have a Ubuntu Xenial base. Now, what it has to do is, if this is the first time you're running the command, then it has to download the image from the internet, and the image can be a few hundred meg to a gig. So it can take a while the first time you run it on your machine, but once that image is cached on your machine and it's already been run, then it's a lot quicker from that point onwards. So it's basically gonna create a box, a base image with this Ubuntu image. It's gonna configure the network to forward this port, and then once the server is up and running, it's gonna automatically run this shell script here. So we're gonna wait for this to complete. If yours is taking a bit longer because it has to download the images or something, then just pause the video, and once the Vagrant file is up and running, continue on and we'll carry on with the lesson. Okay, so once the Vagrant file is up and running, you'll get a response like this. So it outputs all of the commands that it runs on the server, and then it just goes back to our shell and it sends us back to our profile's REST API. So now our Vagrant server is up and running on our machine. We want to connect to the server so that we can actually execute commands on it and manage the Linux server from our system. The way that you connect to a server is you use a different Vagrant command called Vagrant SSH. Now, SSH, if you haven't heard of it before, is something called Secure Shell. And it's a common way, or the most common way, of connecting and interacting with Linux and Unix servers on the internet. So typically it's used to connect to a remote server. So you connect to a remote web server somewhere on the internet, on Amazon Web Services or on DigitalOcean or somewhere. In this case, we're going to use it to just connect to the local server that we created on our machine. So it's simulating a real live server. So type Vagrant SSH and hit enter. And it's going to connect to the server. So now you can see that the window looks a little bit different. You have this output here, and this output is the first time you log in. It configures virtual mwrapper, which is a tool that we're going to be using later. But the screen looks a little bit different now, and that's because we're actually running the commands on the server, the Vagrant server that we've created. So we're no longer running the commands on our local desktop. So anything you type in here is running on our temporary development server. Okay, so that's how you start the Vagrant server and connect to the Vagrant server. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.